Hey everybody, welcome back to another reaction video. Hope you're doing well. My name is Todd. This is Veronica and Logan, The Great War, which is apparently a song by Taylor Swift. This video is requested by a Patreon subscriber. You too can join the Patreon link down below. Description will get you there. Throw a like in the video if you like it. Subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Hit that notification bell. That way you know when videos post immediately. And you can come check it out. And let's go.
You give it to the people you love, but the people who really deserve it.
Now, if you're unaware, I have watched the first episode of Veronica Mars. It was very interesting. I especially liked the dad in the show. He was a interesting character. And pretty clear he's got some secrets.
But pretty clear. Are the ones who come through even when you don't love them enough.
Also, another thing I noticed in the beginning of the show, Logan was kind of a... What's a good way to put this? D-bag?
If I need anyone punched in the face, I'll whistle for you.
So yeah, I blame Veronica.
He's got everything that a high schooler in the early 2000s would have. He's got the slicked up hair, and he's got a damn necklace on. Oh my God.
When I do, Veronica, can you just tell me?
There's no way that at some point while it was happening, you weren't thinking about how much I hate you being with her.
I thought our story was ending, you know? Flashes of the battle come back to me in a blur. You and me.
Epic pal.
Spanning years and continents. Live room, bloodshed, epic. When I dream of this moment, I've had the time of my life as much as I pray. Get out of my house. You have a problem with Veronica, you leave.
It's been a long time, Keith. Yeah. Mom was always nice to me.
Kids don't seem to hang out together much anymore.
We're going to take a tough but survivable amount of pain now. Trust me. And please, have a little faith.
You can trust me.
What's your poison? This trust thing doesn't come naturally.
I want you to trust me.
Like I'm trying to act unnaturally. I swear. I do. What if I feel like with a gun? You're going to get yourself killed.
What's up with Franz and Paige? When we were dating, were they ever, you know?
If you think she was unfaithful, you're...
Oh my God, did you see that? Was that Paris Hilton? And also, Amanda Seyfried? Seyfried?
Maybe I'm missing Lala.
Do you think Lily loved Weevil? You were right.
I know Amanda's in the show. Obviously, Paris was guesting.
Tell me.
Wait a second. You
that was back in the, that was back in the Simple Life days. What a crazy show. Her and Nicole Richie and the whole That's Hot thing was popping off.
It's me and make them pay.
Come on.
You just ruined five. Bloodshed.
Really
think relationships should be that hard?
No, I'm not a killer, Veronica. You know, I'm writing songs about the ones that come easy. I'm always here.
I love you, Veronica. Do you love me?
Yeah.
Can we try to go a little easier on each other?
You're gonna get through this.
Yeah, well,
it's a good idea.
Well, I guess it has been a charmed life. Take care of yourself, Veronica.
The day that Lily was murdered.
Yeah, well, Logan.
You too.
He drove back to Neptune to see her.
He had plenty of time to get back to Neptune and kill her.
Veronica Mars. She's the one who came to me with information about you.
I guess we broke up, huh?
So you're saying you want me dead?
I wasn't trying to hurt you.
Really? Imagine if you tried.
What are you doing there?
Now, what do you think, Veronica? I'm just telling you, Veronica.
You've broken up with me. You accuse me of killing Lily.
I believe you.
I'm so sorry. I know now it wasn't you, and I'm sorry
I accused you.
It's fine, but I keep thinking that things can get worse.
I'm sorry I accused you of murder.
It's not fine. I'm really sorry.
You lost your...
Yeah, no big deal. Don't worry about it.
9 years of radio silence, and yet I still kind of knew deep down I could count on you.
About those 9 years.
Bygones.
Do you remember when we made out against the sink and you had your legs around my waist?
Our story's ending. It's been years.
We find the defendant not guilty.
Logan's had a tough time with Lily's death.
Understandably, Marie's ruined. So has Veronica.
That's
it.
That's my girlfriend.
The worst was over my hand. Was the one you reached
But you have some fun with the ladies, huh?
Come back to
me.
You still have that ring?
The ones that survived.
When I thought, I'm going to die tonight.
You know, Aaron Eccles is staying here. Would you want to bet that I can get him convicted for the death of this teenage girl?
The only person I thought about was Logan.
Bullshit. Do you, Veronica, take Logan to be your lawful wedded husband?
Yeah, why not?
Wow. The age difference in those first years and what looks like to be the last year of that show was crazy. Wow. Link down below in the description for the original video. Go throw out some love. That's an excellent edit. Well, obviously they went through some stuff after that first episode that I haven't seen yet. What a 180 from my initial reaction to their love story to now. Because now I'm just like, whatever. It looks good. It looks interesting. Obviously they went through some stuff and they found each other in the end. But boy, that first edit just tarred my entire opinion of it. And I was just like, oh God. Such a classic story of bad boy turned, he's a bad boy, but he's good for me. He went into the military and he turned out to be a man. Now I'm looking at it a lot differently and it's a lot sweeter than my initial reaction, which was disdain. I don't have a lot to say about Veronica and Logan other than things change, people can change, situations change people. Especially in high school, you can get in with the wrong crowd, wrong friends, and all of a sudden you're just an asshole. Your friends are jerks, and then you turn into a jerk, and then you treat people you actually like awful. Like, so much can happen in high school if you get in with the wrong crowd, or people that aren't great for you, or people who don't have your best interests at heart. You know, I think back to high school at the popular clique. I wasn't a part of it. I don't know what exact clique I was in, but I remember looking at the popular clique, usually jocks and stuff like that, cheerleaders, that kind of thing. And I just think back at that and I go, damn. I wonder how many of those people, when they got older, like went through college, stuff like that, got even older than that, graduated college, didn't go to college, whatever. As they aged, are they looking back at that time and going, man, I was a jerk. I was kind of weird. I shouldn't have been with those people. You know, I was mean to this person. I shouldn't have been. You know, is there that moment where they look back and go, yeah, high school sucked. I was in with the wrong people. I did the wrong things. Or do they look back on it fondly, even though they might have been a jerk to somebody, and they just go, kids be kids. You know, you always hear that story of people looking back and, oh man, I wish I was different. I wish it was nicer, you know, that kind of thing. And you actually wonder if that's actually true or if that's just BS. I can tell you this, after looking back at my own situation, I never treated anyone poorly in high school. And I think it's because of the people I surrounded myself with. They all had good families. They were all nice people. We kind of roasted each other a little bit. Not too much, but every once in a while you get, you know, a joke off on a friend or something like that. But you keep it to your friend group. You don't just start roasting other people or picking fights with other people or stuff like that. So I can look back on my high school career and be fond of it and not be ashamed of it, which is cool. And I think that should be the goal for everyone. You know, go through life, treat people how you want to be treated kind of thing. And not saying I'm an angel, not saying I'm the greatest person alive. Definitely not. But I look back on my school years and I go, you know what? I was okay. You know, kind of slacked off a little bit. Probably could have tried a little harder. But with regards to my interactions with people, I was always very nice. And I don't think I treated anyone too poorly, which is good. Let me know your thoughts. If you've had any time to think about your past, you know, would you change anything? Would you treat people differently? Do you think you were in the right group? You know, because high school and that kind of stuff is always split up into groups. Even adult life, it's split up into groups. on like Instagram. You have the people at the top that just earn an insane amount of money, and they're just posting them getting into private jets and whatnot. Then you have people who, you know, posting their family. Then you have people that are posting, you know, their trips and stuff like that. So even in adult life, we're still kind of self-segregating in a way, like cliques or whatever. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed the video. I will see you on the next one. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye. Thank you.